to tell our friends. Well, one group of Florida fishermen decided to bring back more than just a story from their latest trip. They brought back proof. Over the weekend, a group found a nearly 24-foot giant squid floating off the coast. Lucky for them, it was already dead. Even though the behemoth barely fit in their 23-foot boat, they decided to wrestle it aboard, haul it to land, and hand it over to wildlife officials. What makes the find so amazing is that the giant squid species remains largely a mystery since they live in the depths beyond our reach. Almost everything we know about them comes from dead ones that have washed ashore, or in this case, been found by fishermen. No word on how the group celebrated their find. Maybe over a few beers.
As a kid, I knew them as calamari mostly. But this is an octopus. This is the work of Dr. Roger Hanlon at the Marine Biological Lab. And just fascinating how cephalopods can, with their eyes, incredible eyes, sense their surrounding, look at light, look at patterns. Here's an octopus moving across the reef, finds a spot to settle down, curls up, and then disappears into the background. Tough thing to do. In the next bit, we're going to see a couple of squid. These are squid. Now, males, when they fight, if they're really aggressive, they turn white. And these two males are fighting. They do it by bouncing their butts together, which is an interesting concept. Now, here's a male on the left and a female on the right. And now, the male has managed to split his coloration so that the female only always sees the kinder, gentler squid in him. And the male's on the opposite. We're going to see it again. Let's take a look at it again. Watch the coloration. White on the right. Brown on the left. He takes a step back, so he's keeping off the other males by splitting his body, and he comes up on the other side. Bingo. Now, I'm told that's not just a squid phenomenon with males, but I don't know if that's true. Cuttlefish. I love cuttlefish. This is a giant Australian cuttlefish, and there he is, his droopy little eyes up here. But they could do pretty amazing things, too. Here we're going to see one backing into a crevice. And watch his tentacles. He just pulls them in, makes them look just like algae. Disappears right into the background. Positively amazing. Here's two males fighting. Once again, they're smart enough, these cephalopods. They know not to hurt each other. But look at the patterns that they can do with their skin. Okay? Just an amazing thing. Here's an octopus. Sometimes they don't want to be seen when they move because predators can see them. And here, this guy actually can make himself look like a rock. And looking at his environment, can actually slide across the bottom using the waves and the shadows so he can't be seen. He blends right into his motion blends right into the background. The moving rock trick. So we're learning lots new from the shallow water. Still exploring that deep, learning lots from the shallow water. There's a good reason why. I mean, the shallow water is full of predators. Here's a barracuda. And if you're an octopus or a cephalopod, you need to really understand how to use your surroundings to hide. In the next scene, you're going to see a nice coral bottom. And you see that an octopus would stand out very easily there if you couldn't use your camouflage, use your skin to change color and texture. Here's some algae in the foreground. And an octopus. Isn't that amazing?